So you really want to win this year, huh?
Get out the gate strong with this one, and
this is the one, man.
Have you tried his beer? Is it is he good competition?
I sure haven't.
I'm just like generally curious who murdered my parents.
Like, there's really no way that they could have removed his body without changing the beer.
I came in on a weird conversation, didn't I?
You know, these hipsters.
We'll give you powers beyond your imagination.
I've always thought you brew a good beer.
I'm good at this, man. Here, have some beer.
This is my brewmaster.
You jealous, Marlo? That you can't win a brewing competition with your mediocre beer?
Your facial hair is back.
Memphis, what happened to your mustache?
Well, I mean, it went through a couple treatments.
Give me your f***ing beer.
Is any beers you haven't tried? Have I tried everyone's beers?
I spent 6 months on these peaks brewing this beer. It's perfect.
And it is an aggressively average IPA.
But eventually it became a porter.
Yes, it does have a hint of watermelon.
A nice refreshing beer.
With notes of fresh cut grass reminding you of summer's day.
Somewhere between an ale and a lager.
Very malty.
And it has some really deep, complex notes that you just can't pinpoint.
A little citrusy, nice and light.
And while it's dry hopping, I put that in there.
Yeah, you gotta get that wild yeast from somewhere.
It is a darker beer, very full-bodied.
Fresh and crisp and
strong. What is it?
Gets you drunk fast, you don't gotta drink 20 of them.
It's nice and approachable.
It has chokeberries and dark nuts.
Vanilla and caramel.
It's coriander.
Pumpkin spice and blood.
It is one of the sourest, most bitter, hate-filled liquids I've ever put in my mouth.
And leaves a nice, fresh aftertaste in the back of the throat.
If you get tones of IPA, that's exactly what it is.
Funky beer. I can dig a funky beer.
It has a long history. It took a really long time. And I watched like 4 tutorials.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Nobody can interrupt my words and think. Yeah, that's it.